you want to isolate this black area here. We can, of course, create a selection around the black area to isolate it, but I like working with vectors better because they give you smaller file sizes and they're easier to edit. So we're going to create a vector around the frame. So I'm going to press Z on the keyboard. I'm holding the Z key. I'm not letting go of it. And I'm going to zoom in to the corner here and release the Z key. It'll bring me back to the pen tool, which I had selected. Make sure that you have shape on the options panel on this drop down. Click on one corner, then click on the next. Hold the space bar, pan down, click on the bottom right corner, and then click on the bottom left corner. I'm gonna hold the space bar again, click and drag to pan up, and complete that path. Now the color of the shape really doesn't matter, so I'm just gonna make it red just so that you can see it. There it is, red. What I'm gonna do now is enable the layer for the snowboarder. I'm gonna click and drag her up to the top of the layers panel. And I'm also gonna double tap here on the zoom tool just so we can see the image at 100%. And actually, now that I'm looking at it at 100%, I'm actually gonna right click on it and choose fit on screen so that I can see the entire composition. Then I'm gonna press Control J, Command J on the Mac to duplicate. So now I have two copies. I'm gonna disable the one on the top by clicking on this eye icon, and the one on the bottom here, I'm gonna clip to the shape below it. So with that layer selected, I'm gonna press Control Alt G, Command Option G on the Mac. Then I'm gonna enable the layer right above that, and I'm just gonna make a selection around the snowboarder. So I'm gonna click on the quick selection tool, and I'm simply gonna click and drag around her. Now you don't have to be very precise at this moment, you can just click and drag, and we'll worry about the details later. So we're just gonna select her as quick as we can. So I'm just clicking and dragging, and notice that my selection is not very accurate. You shouldn't spend too much time at this moment. If you select an area like this part here that is obviously not gonna be part of the selection, I'm gonna hold Alt, Option on the Mac, click and drag just to refine that selection just a little bit more. Snowboarder, I'm gonna select that top layer and click on the layer mask icon to create a mask around the snowboarder. So what I'm gonna do now is click on this top layer, hold shift and click on the layer below it so they're both selected, and I'm gonna click on this little chain link icon here to link those two layers. What that allows you to do is when you move one of those layers with the move tool, it moves both. And they can be in different groups and they can be separated, so that allows us to keep those two layers together. What I'm going to do now is press Ctrl T, Command T to transform, to scale this and adjust it accordingly. If you can't see the corner handles that you want to click and drag on, you can press Ctrl 0, that's Command 0 on the Mac, for the bird's eye view that allows you to see all four corner handles. Then I'm going to click and drag on this one here to scale it down by holding Shift Alt, that's Shift Option on the Mac. Now at this point, we can go back and adjust the layer mask if we need to. So I'm gonna zoom in just so we can see the areas that we need to work on. So we need to work on this area and then the blue outline around her body. So we can adjust that by clicking on the layer mask in the properties panel. You can click on mask edge. If you don't see the properties panel, you can go into a window, properties, click on mask edge, and then maybe shift the edge with a negative value and see how that's adjusted. So you can keep adjusting it and making sure that that line is gone, but we don't lose any detail that we want to keep. Also, with this brush selected, I can click and drag here on the hair, and hopefully we'll get a better selection. Which now didn't do that good of a job here, so I'm just gonna leave it like this for now, and then I can come back with the brush tool and fix that in a moment. So I'm gonna press OK. Click on the brush tool, paint with white in areas that I want to keep. So I'm just going to paint with white in these areas here. And I know I'm selecting some of the sky, but that's okay. I'm going to get rid of that by pressing X on the keyboard, which swaps the foreground and background color. And with black, I'm going to paint on that layer mask to get rid of the sky here. Thank you. And I'm not going to take the time to do so now. I will do that after the tutorial and you can see the final image. But I'm just going to go around the entire image and just make sure that everything is masked out accordingly. And in most of these areas, everything seems to be okay. I know we got to work on this area here. And like I said, I'll do that after I'm done with the tutorial and you can see my final results. But for now, we'll just leave it as is. I'm going to press Z on the keyboard, right click, and choose fit to screen. And what we're going to work on now is extra elements that are going to help our composite look much more realistic and much more interesting. So from the Adobe Stock Library, I downloaded two elements we're going to use. We're going to use this shovel with the snow. So let me just double click on that to open that up. And by the way, the links to these files are on the description. You have to download them from Adobe Stock. They're not free, but you can use a watermark preview to practice on. So I would recommend you doing that just so that you can have a way to practice and learn. So the first thing I got to do is get rid of this shovel. So I'm going to click on the lasso tool. I'm going to make a selection around this shovel. And as you can see, it's not very accurate. That's okay. Then I can hold shift and backspace, or you can go into edit, fill to bring up the fill menu. Under contents, choose content aware and press OK. And Photoshop will fill in those pixels and make the shovel disappear. I'm going to press Ctrl D, Command D on the Mac to deselect. And this is what we're going to work with. The first thing that we need to do is mask out the snow from the ground. So I'm going to go into the channels panel and I'm going to look for the channel that's got the most contrast. In this case, the blue channel. I'm going to click and drag on the blue channel and drop it here in the new channel icon to duplicate it. Now with the duplicate channel, I can start making adjustments to it. The first thing I'm going to do is fill with white on the areas that I want to keep for sure. So with the lasso tool selected, I'm just going to click and drag and make a very rough selection on the areas that I know for sure I want to keep, which is all this top part here. Now that I have the selection active, I can fill with white. White is currently my foreground color. To fill with the foreground color, you can hold Alt and Backspace, Option, Backspace on the Mac. Then Control D, Command D on the Mac to deselect. Now we gotta work on this bottom part. There's a feature in Photoshop called Apply Image. If you go into Image, Apply Image, what Apply Image allows you to do is to take an image and apply it onto itself using a blend mode. In this case, we're taking the blue copy, applying the screen blend mode onto itself. So notice what happens here in the snow on the edge. It essentially turns white, which is what we want. You could also, of course, apply a multiply blend mode and it'll give you a different result. In this case, I think I'm going to go with screen, and then I'll just work on the edges in the next step. So I'm going to press OK. And what I'm going to do now is go into Image, Adjustment, Levels, and bring the levels to the right, the dark values to the right, so we have more contrast between the snow and the ground. And remember, we're going to be making a selection. Anything that's white in this screen will be selected. Anything that is black will be deselected. So I'm going to drag this one over to the left a little bit. I'm looking at the edges here. And maybe drag this one to the left as well. And press OK. Now, what I'm going to do now is click on the brush tool, select black as my foreground color so I can paint with black. I'm going to increase the size of my brush by clicking on the right bracket key on the keyboard, and I'm just going to paint with black. And again, you don't have to be very accurate. As long as you get close enough, you should be good. And I'm just painting these pixels away, which represent the floor. And once again, I'm going to go into Image, Adjustment, Levels, and darken up some of the darker pixels and brighten up the midtones a little bit. And press OK. So this selection looks like it'll work. So I'm going to press Control, Command on the Mac, click on the blue copy icon to make a selection around it, go back into the Layers panel. On the background layer, which is the only layer that we have in this document, I'm going to click on the new layer mask icon. And notice now that the floor is no longer there. Now, it's not a perfect selection, but it's going to work because the color of the floor and the color of the table are very similar colors, and I think we're going to be able to get away with it. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to simply click on the layer, select the move tool, click and drag the layer over onto the other file by hovering over the tab, then coming down and releasing, and there's our file. It's a really big layer, so we're gonna need to scale it down. Control T, Command T on the Mac to transform. We can't see the corner handles, so I'm gonna press Control 0, Command 0 on the Mac.